Ladies and gentlemen, I am very pleased to be here. When Alex called me to do the wrap-up, I said immediately yes. And when I lay down the telephone, I thought by myself, how do I make the wrap-up in 15 minutes of this kind of excellent presentation we saw the last 2 days? This is me. If you want to know more of me, please you can look in the booklet. There is my CV and something like that. But first I want to say, to go already a little bit into the direction of the health, it's very pleasant to meet you here in this very nice building. We talked a lot about heritage, and now this is what it is, isn't it? Perfect. I try to find some pictures to help you through the both days. The next one is that I want to say, when we talk about health and urban planning, it means that we are a lot talking about road cycling, walking, used cars, and all, it's all developing very rapidly. And at every product nowadays, you find warnings. And this will be the warning, I think, within a couple of years on cars. And it means get out of that thing. And don't smoke anymore. That doesn't help with me because I'm a pipe smoker. So, but this kinds of warnings we will see. And yesterday, I think Marcus inspired us with an excellent start of the conference. We have to design cities in the future, and we think about all possibilities and not directly in problems and warnings. Innovative leadership. Active leadership, active citizenship is necessary. Health is more, what I wrote down yesterday, than an absence of diseases and infirmity. You can't have healthy people on a sick planet, I think you remember it, or in a sick city. To do something, you need information. Active citizenship, what some leaders don't want because they are afraid of demanding citizens. The next example was the improving of all kinds of health topics in the Barcelona region. I found this on the internet because I remember the case of Barcelona. Of course, we had the Skype meeting, and I was very impressed in the way how they handle government policies in the region. I know, as a former city manager, how difficult it is to get government policies developed in the region, that every municipality does it in the same way. And I think Barcelona region was an excellent example how you can do it. And please make contact with them and learn from it. I wrote down some keynotes for this presentation. Facilitating is necessary. Sometimes it's temporary solutions in open space are necessary, and synergy in policies. That's very important to find your way. Yesterday we saw also examples from three cities, Turin, Utrecht, and Hamburg, and of course Udine, about metropolitan cities. I'm living in the southwestern part of the Netherlands, and there Rotterdam, The Hague is the metropolitan. And this is what we saw a little bit, what I found. People in the surroundings are sometimes afraid of those metropolitans. And what I learned yesterday, that it was very important that you find a way for the governmental structures in the metropolitan region. I thought it was Turin that they talked about a metropolitan mayor, and that is a kind of revolution. I can tell you in this kind of system. Of course, I don't want to forget my dear colleagues from Utrecht. You don't blame a Dutchman, I think, because it was also, I think, impressive how they show how their energy activities of individuals made a part of the policy of the municipality of Utrecht. metropolitans, what I also wrote down, 55% of the world's population is living there, and they use 3% of the surface of our Earth. And still we have to be very careful with our planet. Keynote for me, democratic changes. We have to live with it. We all get gray hair, and we all become elder and healthier. I will tell something about it in a few moments. But how difficult it is to change a society, and that we need an open society, and what I learned yesterday, that they were talking about participatory processes. Green capitals. We learned about green capitals in the past, now, and in the future, because there, we had a municipality who was a green capital of Europe, who is green capital of Europe, and who will become the green capital. It was, for the organization, a perfect mix, I think, that they could tell about their could tell about their projects. What I learned from all the three a little bit yesterday, that they say, you have just to do it. Ljubljana even said regulations, national regulations. No. We just do it in small steps, but we do it. And I like that. Take a little bit risk to realize something in a change. And then you can also show how change can be. And then we already had our second day. I have four slices a little bit, because we talked about mobility and also again about the cross-cutting model of Barcelona for this topic. I will say again something about it. That picture is not so well, but you know what I mean. It was the example. We go back for one. The examples from Modena, Tallinn, and Barcelona, and showing how the struggle is to get people out of the car, into public transport, or even walking. I learned you have to go for the Olympic Games. Because then, what in Barcelona, they said, that could be the next step to that the people are going to sport anymore. If I go in the Netherlands and we ask, we want the Olympic Games in Amsterdam or Rotterdam, they send me away because it's all cost money, etc. But a couple of years ago, I walked around the Montjuïc, you call it, I think, the Olympic Stadium. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. So it's not only waste money in my view. What I also learned is that you have to combine the holistic view with the measurements. WHO policies are very important. The cities want to implement them, and that is what I learned yesterday. But you need local solutions. We have to move and we have to sit less. So that's why I'm standing now. But just a personal opinion. I agree fully with the goal that we have to live more healthier, but isn't also your experience that life is much nicer if you are healthy? But do you also have the same experience as me, that the healthier you live, the more you have to pay, and the less you get from your insurance? That's the Netherlands case. So the rewarding of your healthier life is not that you have profit, but you have to pay more. And that is for some people not always understandable, at least for me. Housing vulnerability. Examples from Liverpool, Saint-Gugat-de-Val, and Ghent. Examples how to help the most poorest people. You have to talk to them, you have to help them, and you have to reach them, and you have to bring them in a situation that they can solve their own problems. Satisfaction with housing is an individual feeling, but it must in a healthy way, of course. Look at the policies and investigations of the mentioned municipalities. We cannot go for easy solutions, I learned. Sometimes you need to use an unorthodox road. Rent and Vienna this afternoon, building a space for healthy living, very interesting examples of how landscape architecture can help us feeling as much happier in the city. I don't have a real picture with that because this presentation were after the lunch. So I searched something, and that could be 21 free advices how you can make your city healthy. That is not, I would have liked to find pictures for those presentations, but sometimes you have to do what you have to do. But especially, I want to say that the story about the trees is very nice. We are also planting a lot of trees. Where is our professor? And I want to tell you something. That is not, that's not a joke or something, but perhaps it's also in France. But in the Netherlands, we have a psychological streaming that can teach you how you can talk with trees. And people feel healthier by that. And you have to you have to embrace them, and you almost did with your with your sentiment. But and then you can talk to they give rest, and of course for the CO2 pollution, it's very good to plant trees. When I started as a secretary, every year we had a yearly day for the schools that they could adopt places where they planted trees because of the cuts. It's all over now. It's not nice, but very interesting to listen to. What do I want? And then we have. That's my last one already, but the presentation of Isabel was very interesting about how you how the urban urban planning and what we have to do in it, and also that climate change, technical developments, energy, you have to use it. We also talked about it yesterday for the situation in Hamburg. But last of all, ladies and gentlemen. It was very often said, we need patience, we need time, we need, you have to think about what you have to do. This is my last slide, and I put it on patience, but I want to express that I don't hope that we take as much time as that we are now building the Sagrada. Thank you very much for this excellent conference.